stupid script.
Hi there, I'm Abby. Welcome to the Valentine Studs, where I'm going to be meeting up with three potential dates for Valentine's Day. I've decided to pick three of my exes from the past, just to see how their lives are doing and if they would be my potential partner in the present. Let's see how it goes.
My name is Xavier by birth, but I prefer to be called X, because X is my spirit number.
I'm Josh, Josh Woodsman. You probably know my father, Joseph Woodsman. He owns Woodsman Clothing Enterprises.
It's been all those years, all the years, all of them, four years, 3 months, and 2 days since I've last seen Abby.
Hey guys.
Hey!
Hey! Is it really you?
So here's how it works. I'm going to interview all three of you separately. And at the end of it, we'll see how the dating process goes, and I'll pick my Valentine for this year.
That sounds really awesome. I can't wait. Oh, she's gonna choose me. All right, fine. I'll try to be patient.
How about you just be patient, okay? You know, this takes time.
Yeah.
Fine.
I'm not trying to. It's just dating, man. Like, why do you take it so seriously?
Why do you take yourself so seriously?
I take a lot of seriously.
Because I have a.
That's what I thought. Shut up.
I have my fair share with the company, fundings and distribution. Of course, when my father, passes away, of course.
Oh man, I get goosebumps just thinking about it. But she's dated some pretty terrible men in that time.
No way I think it ever best me in anything. In fact, I've managed to ace them at both swimming, football, and track.
Right, X. It's been about 6 years since we dated.
High school feels like it was just yesterday.
Yeah, time flies.
sure it does, babe. Well, maybe not so much for me, because I gotta do what I can to find that fountain of youth. I'm gonna continue to find that fountain of youth until I get stronger and even better than every athlete, including that Tom Brady fucker.
Fine, I agreed to wear this over it, but they want me to take these off. Come on, I don't want to take these fucking things off. These are a part of me. I mean, these are what I used to work on. I've been working on these since I was 14 or something, or whatever.
Abby's never going to resist me. Actually, she never resisted me. Along with these guns right here.
So, Josh, how are you?
I'm feeling rather good. Very confident, actually.
Yeah, it's been quite a while.
Oh, yes. 5, 6 years?
4.
4? Oh, thank you. Yeah, after dating for, what, like a year?
A month.
Oh, yeah, died prematurely, but whatever. Look, I think I am a very classy type. I mean, that's what the ladies like, right? So, what's the occasion, huh?
Well, I guess I just wanted to get some old friends together, you know?
Well, I hope that we become more than friends, you know what I mean?
How has your dating life been the last few years without me?
Well, I guess I can't really say too many good things, but...
Did you miss me at all?
I don't know, things change and people change and...
Well, I don't change. Maybe it's because I'm too much like my Mormon family, but...
That was the best 20 minutes of my life. This is where the real stuff happened.
I have good memories here.
Oh my
goodness. One of those memories back, way back in high school, and you know this. I was the fastest and the best of the best track runner in high school. I'm already faster than that Sonic and that Roadrunner character. Let's see why the coyote try to catch up with me.
You must be proud of yourself.
Proud of myself? I'm proud of myself every day. Including every night. With every sleep that I get. I even tell myself that I'm proud of myself in my sleep. That I'm the best.
You ever been to the Bahamas?
I haven't.
I have a private mansion around there. Would you like pool?
I do.
Oh, billiards, pool type of gal?
Yeah. Oh, I mean, okay, I play cool. When I go out to the bar.
Oh, that's nice.
And you know what? Compared to those other guys, I think I really nailed it with this one. Yeah. In fact, I even think I did better than those guys. So much better.
You're no longer in the shot. This is my time. This is my time, X.
So much better that those guys are just losers compared to me.
Well, thank you for getting the name right this time. And plus, you know what though?
Yeah, this may be your time now, but I'm just here for the camera. Compared to me, I'm a winner and they're the real losers.
Abby, why are you trying to date these idiots?
You know.
Okay.
Okay, fine. She doesn't have to answer that. I'll just let you guys go on with your stupid interview or some sorts.
I mean, did you see that tall guy with the red voice? I'm not gonna lie to you, he came off as a real weirdo.
Morons.
Give him something. He is a funny character, but not as funny as me.
How's it been?
Well, it's been an interesting few years, you know. A little lonely, a little busy, a little bit of everything, pretty much.
This is an interesting place. Is this yours?
Oh no, this is a rental.
Rental?
I guess I have a few places I like to stay.
I'm just glad that you're giving me a chance.
Yeah, it's always nice to
catch up. Yeah, you know, I know how to play a few swings here and there. You know, I'm a good tennis player.
Righty or lefty?
I'm a righty. This is my writing pen. This is where I make my final deals.
I don't know what to expect of how this date is going to go, but I have the experience. I've been to different countries.
Oh, and you know what else I forgot to add? Swim. Yes, I was also the fastest swimmer. You also know this too? Sucks the best that maybe they should crown me as King of Atlantis. That I can make him go kiss his ass, bro. I care. Fastest swimmer, King of Atlantis. Yeah, he's a pussy.
Yeah, I think the last time I saw you, we were at the MoMA. It was, I don't know, you look kind of out and you were on your phone a lot.
Well, I guess I was a little distracted.
I guess I wanted to know why you asked me back on this show.
I guess you could call the show a little bit of luck, but I mean reasonable. That's never been my style.
Yeah, you always were a little bit out of luck. I mean, you always were pretty beautiful, but I had to take the parts of you that I didn't understand with my very strict ideology. You know, I think I did it good. All that time.
Yo, you know what else I kicked ass in besides swimming and track? Football. It was a dumb sport, but then I tried it, gave it a shot, and hell to the yeah, baby! I rocked that sport just like I did my other two. Eli Manning got nothing on me. I made a score every touchdown that I could make.
Do you remember that time when me and my friend Nina went with you to Brazil?
Nina?
Long brown hair. You know, she had a bit of an accent.
Was she Brazilian?
She was.
Tan skin?
Yeah.
Very unanimously.
I don't want to give away too much, because then that might give up my source as well.
Look, I have not seen Nina for like, I don't know how long.
Because, I mean, it is a beautiful country.
Well, as you must know, I have a factory in Brazil for distribution purposes.
What kind of distribution, may I ask?
You know me and my father run a clothing line. Woodsman Clothing Enterprises. He was in People Magazine, for Christ's sakes.
You know what? I agree.
One second.
Oh. What the fuck's wrong with you?
You're gonna try to ruin my groove, man?
What groove, man?
I'm trying to move the fuck out of here. You know, that douchebag, if he comes in to my fucking dating thing like that or anything,
during this fucking event, I'm probably gonna kick him in the balls.
And that wrist knob? Oh, please, I've already dealt with two. I've already, made fun of, those douchebags.
I think it went rather well, I have to say. I'm pretty much confident that I'm obviously the winner.
So, you see yourself as a true warrior?
A modern Greek Olympian warrior!
I think I nailed it in that interview. I think I really nailed it.
And my dad yelled at me a lot. But I knew you were special. You were the first girl that just decided to talk to me.
Well, I guess everybody needs it sometimes, right?
Man, my life's been pretty shitty the last 4 years. My dad decided that my degree was not useful in his sugar mill. My stupid degree is pretty useless where I live.
The conversation went well. At minute 4:23, she smiled at me with such a beautiful and angelic smile.
And also, what is that tall guy? I've been getting Jeffrey Dahmer vibes from him. Or was it Ted Bundy? John Wayne Gacy? I don't know. Don't care.
It's so fluffy.
Oh. I was gonna say I have a soft side, but you know, I always keep my soft side to you.
Sorry. Let's sports. You gotta cut that off, right?
I have my car outside, all nice sophisticated, still waiting for my majestic purple. Told those workers so many times to get that tone right, the color. I don't care if you have children waiting at home, purple, two of them, please, whatever. I just want you to be out. I'm gonna hire somebody else. Go away. Screw you. Bye. Please. Oh, we're still on the interview?
I got caught off guard by one of her smiles, and I think I could tell by, I've been reading the book on nonverbal cues, and I could tell.
Gentlemen, we're near the end of the Valentine's special, and I'm ready to give you all my choice. But first, I would like to tell you all the second real reason why I've brought you here today.
Go ahead. Oh, really? What's the second thing?
Yeah. What is it?
We'd all like to know.
But Xavier. Or X.
Yes, it's X, babe. Whatever. Okay. You got that right.
Well, I know you treasure yourself as the biggest and baddest guy out there.
That's true.
But I think we both know the real truth.
Wait, what truth?
Do you remember the summer of 2012? The track and field tryouts?
Yeah, I remember the 2012 tryouts.
You didn't make it, did you?
All right. You know what? Fine. I admit. You know what? Fine. I admit. I didn't make it into the tryouts.
No.
I didn't.
Not you, but someone else did, right?
What are you getting at?
Do you remember Axel Newton?
Axel? Yeah, I remember Axel. Yeah, he was a good guy.
Oh yeah, he's supposed to be the most potential runner-up for the Olympics for the track and field.
Yes, it was.
Well, he was the one who won the tryouts, right?
Yes.
Yeah, an accident mysteriously occurred right after that, where he was driving his Toyota RAV4 and crashed due to a faulty brake system. Weird, huh?
Accusing that I'm the one that killed him?
Well, isn't your 2010 Jeep Wrangler the one that was parked right next to Axel's car before the accident?
No! I really seriously don't know what you're bitching about, babe. Come on.
Now, you and I both know the secret that I've left out of this special.
Dude, she's got you in the corner, man.
Stop! Oh, stop, baby, you're
whatever, X. Your muscles will have to wait for the juice after this special. Josh.
Yes.
Well, I've got something for you too next.
Hey, go ahead. What do you got for me?
You may think you're worth $1 million, but I think there's a secret that goes a little bit deeper than that.
What do you mean?
Deep inside your hollowed soul, I think you truly know what happened in Brazil.
What about Brazil?
Oh, did you leave your soul there too?
It's right here. I didn't leave it. What are you talking about?
Well, does the name Nina ring any bells?
Yeah, we talked about it.
Very true, but I think you and Nina have a bit of a past yourselves.
A past?
Dear Joshua,
Nina Ferrero was a very close friend of mine. She disappeared about 4 years ago. Ironic, because you and I had just broken up for about a month right before.
Yeah, that's true, true.
Well, just before the incident, Nina told me that her and her family were having some financial troubles with a company that they were working for.
What does that have to do with me?
Well, it was this particular factory that let them all go, and that factory was your daddy's factory.
Shouldn't we run now?
And she mentioned something of a vacation in the Caribbean.
Damn, that woman does not know when to shut up.
Isn't it strange, Josh? Because her mentioning you was the last time I saw or heard from her. Well, you might think you've gotten away with it this time, but sooner or later, your daddy's money won't get you very far in life.
I don't know what you're getting at, but I have a good lawyer that'll back me up for this, for something I have never done. Never!
That's what they all
do. And you forget about the trip to the Bahamas, for that matter.
Oh, let me guess, you got thrown out of here too.
This so easily.
What are you talking about?
I know what your game is, but I'm a hard catch yet. You know that?
Yeah.
I know you have pictures of me on your wall now. Pictures that you've taken following me around everywhere I go. Oh, sorry.
So what is she getting at, Matthew?
She's saying...
Have you been following me around all this time because you care about me, or because I'll be the next victim in your collection? I know about your collection. It's a kink, I get it. But one that only lasts about 2 or 3 weeks, and it's never enough.
Hey, Miss Rangel, leave, pathetic!
Come on! Get on!
And you, Xavier!
No!
Wait, wait, wait! No! Olivia Kathleen!
Oh!
I can rip your arms off!
Please don't!
Yes, and I also know what you've been doing with those ladies all this time in your shed.
What are you looking at?
My folks are gonna kill me.
Abby, let's... We should bail.
My lawyer! Someone call my lawyer!
You know you're not gonna do anything to me, Matthew. I've got too much on you. That's it for this special. I'll see you guys next time.
Ew, Beth!
Well, that's it for the Valentine's special, guys. All I can say is, be careful who you're dating. And what uncertainties lie behind their public personas. What I did was risky, but necessary. Would they be out of jail, or would they be released without a trial? I don't know. But I did what I could, and that's all that matters. This will leave a mark on them for the rest of their lives. Now, I should get going. I have a date with an investigator named Emery.
Some flowers.